old. This clothes basket is heavier than a bucket full of hog's livers. Don't touch it. It's ancient.
I bet you little Jasper crawled in there to get warm.
Who in tarnation is little Jasper?
Ain't he cute, Granny?
I declare another pussycat. This one's all broke out with spots.
This here little feller's what you call a jaguar.
Where'd he come from?
Critter Doc drove to zoo, said he comes all the way from South America.
Down Louisiana way. Nice country. He'll bring you home to wing.
He says, I got away with the critters.
You better get away with this one before your paw sees it. He's getting a craw full of you dragging home them critters.
Where is Pa?
Out front, sold him shoes.
Come on, little Jasper. I'd better hide you, baby.
One nail us together, Pearl. My doggies, it's good to see you.
It's good to be here.
I thought I heard Pearl's voice.
Jenny! Granny!
You old rascal, you surprised us. How are things back home?
Fine as frog's hair.
Why didn't you let us know you was coming? We'd met you at the airport.
Oh, Daddy spoiled the surprise. Besides, I didn't want to take Jethro out of school. And Mr. Drysdale offered his limousine and livered chauffeur. Thanks a heap.
Kid, give the chauffeur a tip.
Come on, Pearl. Come inside. Tell me all about it.
Just a minute, young feller. Got a tip for you.
Thank you, sir.
Plant your corn early this year.
Good to see you.
Well, tell us all about Jethrine getting married.
Did you have a big fancy wedding in your parlor?
Sure she did. Pearl's been planning that for years.
It didn't quite come off the way I planned it.
What happened?
You know, I had Jethrine all set to marry Albert Ledbetter, that tall spring bean of undertaker over to Ripley.
Good, steady fella, Al. Best undertaker in the whole county.
Only undertaker in the county.
Nice fella, too.
Oh, Granny. I wish you could have seen the way he decorated my parlor. Well, you couldn't walk for the flowers. They weren't all strictly fresh, mind you, and some of them still had the black ribbons on them.
Flowers is flowers.
Well, never was one to waste nothing.
Well, what happened, Aunt Pearl? Didn't Cousin Jethrine marry up with undertaker?
Stood him up, loped with another man.
There goes my free funeral.
Well, tell me, Pearl, who'd Jethrine lope with?
That drummer from Joplin, Jasper Depew.
Why, he weren't no more than half her size.
I reckon love ain't measured by a yardstick, Granny. And they do look happy. Sent me a snapshot from Turnersville.
How'd old Al Ledbetter take it, Pearl? Jethrine stand him up like that?
Took it right nasty, Jed. He backed his hearse up to the door and hauled away every single flower.
Where'd he take him?
Straight over to Elverna Bradshaw's parlor. He up and married her daughter before them flowers could wilt.
Well, never was one to waste nothing.
Hello, Jed, I gotta have...
Hello, son.
Ma!
Come and see.
Jethro, put me down. Jethro, what are you doing home from school in the middle of the morning?
Did you hear your ma was coming home?
No, Uncle Jed. They just found out over at school that I ain't got no certificate of health.
What's that?
That's something that says that I'm healthy.
I'm saying you're healthy. Now, go on back to school.
I gotta have an examination first, Granny.
Stick out your tongue. You're healthy. Get back to school.
Granny, I reckon he's gotta be examined by a doctor.
I've been doctoring better than 60 years.
It's gotta be a doctor that's what they call a M.D.
What does that stand for?
Mr. Doctor, I reckon.
Well, I'm an M.D. Mrs. Doctor.
Man, maybe he ought to do like the school says,
City doctors.
Trouble is, we don't know no doctors.
Well, I know the critter doctor over to the zoo.
Jethro's a human being, Ellie Mae.
Thank you, Ma.
Why don't we ask Miss Drysdale? I hear tell she's been to every doctor in Beverly Hills.
Hey, Marie the maid told me about a doctor she's been going to for 7 years.
He must be a crackerjack. What's his name?
Let me think. It commences with D. I got it! Dr. Twombly!
Twombly don't commence with a D.
Well, doctor does.
Jethro, you go on upstairs and take a bath and put on some clean underwear and get over and see him.
Okay, Ma.
I sure hope Dr. Twombly don't examine his brains.
Analysis is progressing most satisfactorily. Tomorrow, same time.
Yes. Well, thank you, Dr. Twombly.
And don't worry about the regression into infancy syndrome. You'll overcome this desire to be a baby again.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Doctor. Thank you.
You thought you had some beauties, Dr. Freud.
Oh, doctor, there's one more patient. His name is Jethro Bodine.
This is my golf day. You know I don't take patients after 11 o'clock.
He was referred by Mrs. Drysdale.
Oh, all right. Call Dr. Black and tell him I'll meet him on the golf course at 12:15.
Yes, doctor. This is Jethro Bodine.
Howdy.
How are you, Jethro? Make yourself comfortable on the couch, right here.
Thank you.
Well, would you like to tell me all about yourself and why you're here?
Well, why I'm here is that I can't go to school till I get examined by you.
Yes, sir. Just lie back and relax.
Well, thank you.
Now, suppose you tell me about this problem you're having at school.
Well, my biggest problem is staying awake while the teacher's talking.
Well, that might be nothing more than a benign subconscious rejection of authority represented by the teacher. It doesn't mean that you necessarily lack interest or capability or intelligence. Above all, you mustn't let this cause you any distress. Together, we will probe into the underlying causations and... So good to feel needed.
Hey, May, this little critter just scared the living daylights out of your Aunt Pearl. Now, something tells me it just might be yours.
I'm awful sorry, Paul. I plumb forgot I hid him in Aunt Pearl's dresser drawer.
He just loves to get in betwixt clothes and snooze.
Give me a terrible start, Ellie. I thought it was a fur muffin. Started to stick my hand in and he bit right down on it. Oh, I let out a yell, I can tell you.
I heard you clean down to the cement pond. You're yodeling better than ever.
Granny, I was
yodeling. I reckon a quarry critter like this ought to be outside instead of in the house scaring folks.
Oh, leave her, stagehead. I'm commencing to like her yodeling.
Oh, Granny.
Has anybody heard anything of Jethro? He's been at that doctor for a good spell now.
Ah, rest easy, Pearl. There's a lot of boy there to examine.
Now, Jethro, during your few waking moments, you have managed to tell me that your mother's a widow.
Oh, yes, sir.
I'd like you to tell me all about your mother. I'm very interested in her.
Don't blame you. She's pretty.
That's fine. Now then, Jethro, what's your relationship to your mother?
I'm her son.
Yes, I know that. But how do you feel about her? Do you like her?
Oh, I sure do. She's a dandy, huh?
Does she ever give you hostile emotions or aggressive tendencies?
Well, she would if I asked her for them.
Yes, well, suppose we talk about your father. Do you remember him?
Oh, yes, sir. He used to take me hunting. Taught me how to shoot with a rifle when I was just a little feller.
Oh, you were good buddies when he was alive.
Oh, yes, sir.
Did you miss him?
I never shot at him.
Well, suppose you tell me about the rest of your family. Do you have any brothers?
No, sir. But I got a sister that's got one.
Well, that would be you, Jeff.
No, sir. Her name is Jethrine.
Why don't you go back to sleep for a while?
Oh, Granny, wait till you see what all's in here. Everlasting you asked me to bring back from the hills.
Oh, bless you, Pearl.
But coon root.
Pearl, you'll never know how I needed this. When you simmer this in slippery elm tea, it is first rate for chills and fever.
Dried crawdad tail.
Ooh. Big rascals, too. When they is ground up to powder, you can't beat it for easing headaches, curing warts, and seasoning sauerkraut.
Catfish whiskers.
Oh.
Soap water.
Oh.
Dogwood bark. Oh.
And the skins from 3 full-grown newts caught at midnight under a full moon.
Pearl, you ain't gonna believe this, but you just can't buy these in Beverly Hills.
That's a fact, Pearl. Jethro drove me up to 5 big department stores out here, and not one of them had a newt skin.
When it comes to charms and potions, you might just as well not commence unless you got the midnight moonlight caught fully grown newt.
Earl, did you do all this gathering yourself?
Oh, no, not yet. I had company, especially for the midnight moonlight newt hunt.
Anybody I know?
Oh, 3 of the most marriageable men in the hills.
Well, that'd be Jack Cantrell, Widower Lloyd, and Old Man Casey.
Oh, he ain't so old. I declare, I had to watch out more for him than the newts.
I'm surprised you didn't get married while you was back home, Pearl.
I had plenty of chances, Granny, but I got sport living out here. So I'm gonna hold out for one of them good-looking, snappy-dressing, money-spending Beverly Hills fellas. Wild honeycomb.
Honeycomb and Mountain Dew. Best thing in the world for Quincy.
Mountain-grown flaxseed.
Nothing better for poultices.
Old George McQueenie sent that to you.
Oh, I'll take it anyway.
Ma! Ma!
Well, what'd the doctor say? Are you well? Are you healthy?
I never did find out. But when that Dr. Twombly heard that you was my ma, that's all he talked about from then on.
He talked about me?
He must ask a dozen questions about you.
But, Jethro, I don't even know the man.
Well, he sure knows about you. And he'd like you to come to his office to see him.
When?
Well, he says the sooner the better. And he's a good looker, too.
Bet you Mrs. Drysdale told him about me. I'll hurry and put on my star-bought hair and my society dress.
Jethro, this Dr. Twombly a pretty nice fella?
Yes, sir. But he's awful nosy, though. Never stops asking questions.
Shows he's interested.
But there's one thing about him Ma ain't gonna like. He's a messy writer.
Yeah?
Yes, sir. You know how Ma's always fussing at me for spilling ink in my writing book?
Yeah?
Well, he showed me one of his books, and Uncle Jed, it's the biggest mess of ink blots you ever saw.
Doggy Bear, you're prettier than sun up on a Monday morning.
Ma, that dress shines like a new tin can.
Well, I reckon that's just about the fanciest dress ever.
Even the things that don't show is fancy.
I got the truck waiting, Ma.
Jethro, that truck's a mite breezy when you're wearing high society clothes and someone else's hair. I'm going in style today.
I'll get the door, Ma.
Howdy. At your service, Mrs. Bodine.
Now, this is the way to live. Oh, I just hope that doctor's looking out his window when I drive up.
Au revoir.
Ain't no two ways about it. When it comes to style, nobody plows a deeper rut than Pearl.
Mrs. Bodine, how nice to see you. I'm Dr. Twombly.
Bonjour, s'il vous plaît, I'm sure.
You obviously are a more sophisticated woman than I was led to believe.
Merci, Miss Pa.
Excuse me. Step over to the couch and make yourself comfortable. Oh, sit down. Sit down. Relax. Let's get acquainted. What's the matter?
Don't you get the wrong idea just because I talk French.
Mrs. Bodine, you don't.
You bet I don't.
Here you are, Doctor. And I postponed your golf date until 3.
Thank you.
Dr. Twombly?
Yes, but I'm busy right now.
I'm sorry. You cannot see the doctor without an appointment.
I wouldn't count on that, ma'am. It might be a good idea for you to leave the room.
Who are you?
Name's Jed Clampett, blood cousin to Pearl Bodine.
Good. It's all right, nurse. Mr. Clampett, I'm glad to see you.
Before I shake your hand, maybe I better speak my piece.
By all means. Sit down.
I'd rather stand, thanks, and I'll get right to the point. Back where I come from, we don't take kindly to anybody trifling with our female kinfolks.
But, Mr. Clampett, I
take into account that this is a big city, and your ways are probably different than ours. When my cousin Pearl tells me she had no more than said howdy, and you commence pulling her to the settee, my doggies, that's dropping a rusty bucket down my well.
Mr. Clampett, you don't understand. I do this every day. I'm a psychiatrist.
Well, I'd try to get cured of it if I was you. Unless you're liable to wind up bad hurt.
Well, let me explain and apologize for the mistaken impression.
You can come out the house, explain to Granny, and apologize to Pearl.
I'd love to come to your house. I want to meet every member of your family.
Well, that'll be fine. But keep a tight hold on your feelings. I reckon Cousin Pearl can look after herself, but I got a daughter, Ellie Mae. And I catch you making one move in her direction, you're gonna find yourself weighing about 3 bullets heavier.
Pearl, drink the sassafras tea. I bolstered it up with a little Mountain Dew. Calm you down.
Thank you, Granny.
Pearl, I wish you'd wear this thing or put it away. I keep thinking it's one of Ellie's critters. A bit ago, I tried to feed it a saucer of milk.
Pearl? You do something different to your hair? Oh, Pearl, Jethro and me have brought that Dr. Twombly home here so he could apologize to you.
No mirror in here. I hope you didn't whoop him to where he's no good for shooting.
Ain't gonna shoot nobody, Granny. That's why I come in here first.
You whooped him too bad, huh?
Didn't whoop him at all.
How come?
Poor fella's so sickly, he gotta have a nurse handy all the time. Jethro, bring him on in here. Dr. Twombly, this here is Granny.
I'm pleased to meet you, Granny.
He don't look too sickly to whoop.
You want me to whoop him, Granny?
You go look for some chores.
What, for instance?
Put some air in the truck tires.
They won't hold no more air, Uncle Jed.
Well, then let some out and then put some in.
I never get to do anything I want to do. Somebody's always saying, do this, do that, put air in, take air out. I don't know.
Granny, where's Ellie?
She's out back running a new Jaguar around the yard.
Well, I'll go fetch her. I reckon you'll be safe with him.
doctor.
Thank you.
So, you call yourself a doctor, do you?
Well, I do hold several degrees.
All right, doctor. How do you cure warts?
Warts?
Yeah, warts.
Well, dermatology isn't my field, but I assume electrodesiccation is still the preferred method. Oh, is there a newer method?
Stump water and lime, mixed with ground up crawdad tails, daubed on with the leg bone of a buzzard, just before the moon comes up. Think you can remember that?
Well, I'll try.
Mm-hmm. How do you cure quinsy?
Quinsy? Tonsillitis.
No, that wouldn't cure it.
It's an inflammation of the pharyngeal area.
I don't care what you call it, that wouldn't cure quinsy. Quick, what kind of poultice for rising in the ear?
Poultice?
What's acidity for?
Well,
How would you cure the vapors? What about the drowsies? Aching joints, stone bruises, corns, dander, twinges, and proud flesh.
These things are outside my field.
A doctor goes where he's needed. He don't just stay on his own land.
Now, you sit right back down. Remember what I told you? Hey, this here is Dr. Twombly.
Howdy.
How do you do? Are you the young lady with the new Jaguar?
I sure am. You want to see it?
Well, yes, I'm an enthusiast myself. Is it in the garage?
No, out in the yard. Come on.
Now, you sit right there. Get a me. Bring it in the house.
A Jaguar in the house?
Is it all right, Paul?
Yeah, as long as you don't take it upstairs again.
Bonjour again, Doctor.
Oh, Mrs. Bodine, I am so sorry my actions in the office were misconstrued.
They was downright forward, but if you want to court me proper, you can come into the parlor.
Uncle Dan, looky here.
How'd that happen?
Well, I was blowing air into it like this here. When all of a sudden, pow!
Jethro, I told you, use the pump. You always wash the tires when you blow them up by mouth.
Okay, Ma. Hey, is he gonna be my new daddy?
Me?
I reckon that's up to him, Jethro. We do have a nice parlor for proper courting.
Watch out, Pearl. Here comes Ellie and her Jaguar.
Oh, goodbye, folks. It's been weird.
Doctor, we got a big couch in the parlor.
Yes, I suggest you get on it, all of you. I'll send someone over.
Well, of all the... He run out on me.
Hey, Ma, you want me to catch him and tote him back?
Let him go.
But, Granny, it might be my only chance to get a Beverly Hills doctor.
Doctor, my foot. Unless Ellie brings home a 6-foot duck, you ain't never gonna run into a bigger quack.
Thank you.